When it comes to renting a car, we believe there's only one place to go. National Car Rental. So what are you waiting for? Call National at 1-800-CAR-RENT.
You're watching Fox Sports, home of the NFL, NHL, and Major League Baseball.
Roll with the flow.
I always hated that dynasty.
On Frasier.
Tomorrow at 6:30 on Fox 33.
What explains this passion? Is it physical attraction or the chance to save money? The roasted beef is very juicy. The cheddar cheese is so hot. Is that what is driving so many people wild? Or is it the fact that the Arby's melt is now just 99 cents? Sex is so much easier to figure out.
You can go anywhere and get filled up, but you can only get a 99 cent deal this good at Arby's.
Come on down to Wacky Wireless World. Buy three phones, get your fourth for only a buck, bucko. When you sign up for 96 months of service, it's fabulous! Half off off-peak, double on-off-peak, 89 cents a minute before 5109 after 6, and a free shopping bag absolutely free.
Wacky Wireless World! Feels so good, they're wacko!
Don't think so, because with GTE, it's simple. $35, 150 local minutes. Use them anytime. No smoke, no mirrors, no wires. GTE Wireless.
Why shop the department stores when S&K has thousands of suits on sale? Right now, you can take home two S&K suits for less than you'd expect to pay for one department store suit. And you get two for under 200 bucks. So pick up your next double play at S&K.
Krusty the Clown, a crook?
Hand over all your money in a paper bag.
The Simpsons.
Monday at 6 on Fox 33.
Join me weeknights at 11 on Fox 33.
But that's a pretty good plan.
They also know a few things that they can do. One, they know that Raymond Harris can run. Their offensive line can get some holes. They also know that they can get some passing going, that they can throw to their outside receivers as long as they keep it to the right side.
Those of you who watched Detroit upset Green Bay, welcome to Texas Stadium. Pat Summerall with John Madden, where the Bears lead the Cowboys 3-0. They took the opening kickoff and drove the entire length of the field while they started at their 20. Settled for a field goal and lead 3-0. This will be the Cowboys' first possession. And it's going to be Herschel Walker out of the end zone. Herschel's 35, looks like, and plays like 25, they say. The Cowboy offense led by 9-year veteran Troy Aikman. Its percentage of completion is third all-time. 2-A Newton Shiver, Allen and Williams in front of him. Emmett Smith and Darrell Johnston, Anthony Miller and Michael Irvin wide, and Eric Bjornsson starts at tight end. We'll see a lot of their first-round draft choice from this year, LaFleur.
And there was some question as to whether Larry Allen was going to be able to play today. And
yep,
we're going to check him in the pregame warm-up, and you can see that he is starting.
Number 73, quick count. Aikman back to throw. Flag on the play. As Irvin caught the pass, but it may have been offensive interference.
Well, every time Michael Irvin goes out, he is going to do some pushing. And then the defensive back is going to do some pushing back. So it's who they saw first or who they're going to call them, but I'll guarantee you they both push.
Pass interference, defense.
On the
number
defense.
27.
Was not Michael Irvin.
He's declined. The catch is accepted. First down.
You see Michael Irvin has his hand. You see where it is there? He's pushing off of Walt Harris there. And now Harris comes up, and you see Michael Irvin goes to push him again. And when Michael Irvin goes to push Walt Harris grabs his jersey. So they got him for holding.
They both got away with something.
But, you know, in this league, that is something that they're really letting get way away from them, and that's the offensive wide receivers pushing off.
First down. Intended for Darrell Johnston. It was short. Incomplete. The Bear defense. Reeves, Simpson, Flanagan, and Theory up front. Reeves replacing Alonzo Spellman, Minter, Cox, and Cox. Bryan in the middle, Ron on the outside. Harris, Mangum, Marty Carter, and Tom Carter in the secondary. Two Coxes and two Carters.
Cross up, reverse! Reverse!
Yeah, the first thing you do on defense is you call out the formation. Go right this half.
Here's Aikman with time. Complete. They're looking and pointing. Anthony Miller, the intended target.
I think Walt Harris just came across and ran into his own guy. Let's just watch Larry Allen. You know, we talk about guys that are the best and say that, you know, he's the best offensive lineman in football, and you kind of watch why, and just some of the things that he does. I mean, he is so powerful when he first punches his guy that initial punch is sometimes enough for complete pass protection.
He had a very deep hamstring pull coming into this game. And there was, as John Madden said, a lot of doubt about whether or not he'd play. As Davis in motion with Aikman back to throw him. Pressure on Aikman. Incomplete. He just had to throw it away.
Hey, and Brian Cox was on him, too. Brian Cox was coming from that backside. Yep. And if Aikman doesn't throw it away, he's getting ready to level him. You're just going to see Aikman is going to go back, and then he's going to start to the outside. And here comes Brian Cox right here, number 52. And there's a point there that Aikman can feel that coming, and he just gets rid of it. Of course, John Theory was there doing a good job of containment also.
Going back to punt it. And back deep for the Bears, Tyrone Hughes. Good snap. Not a great kick, but okay. Takes a good bounce. Runs away from Hughes. The Cowboys are going to down it inside the 5 and about the 2. And a flag on the play way back at the line of scrimmage. Billy Davis is the Cowboy who downed it. They've done a wonderful job on special teams, the Cowboys have.
Yeah, and Billy Davis has been one of those guys that have done a wonderful job. That's why he's on this team, although in preseason he was pretty good as a wide receiver, but he's a heck of a special teams player.
Holding. I can't believe they're going to decline this. Although that was a preliminary indication.
You know how far that punt went?
No.
72 yards.
Number 48. Half the distance to the goal line. First down.
Let me think about this one now. Half the distance to the goal line.
That would be a big battle.
That's 1 yard.
Who cares for the past or behind?
Wouldn't you love to be free? To go wherever your whims take you. Whenever you want. For any reason at all.
Along with a tumbling tumbleweed.
With Southwest, you can.
You are now free to move about the country.
I believe in the power of the beer vendor. That one man with one beer born in the Rockies can refresh thousands. I believe in the perfect pour. Frost Brewing. Cold beer, warm heart. I believe that the three most important words on earth are hey, beer, man. That if a vendor can't get you your Coors Light at its ultimate refreshment level, it's a darn shame. And I believe in comfortable shoes.
For milk 3 days ago. Come home now.
It's just more fun to drive. The all-new Accord from Honda.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Southwest Airlines, with fares so low you have the freedom to fly. By the 1998 Honda Accord, an Accord like no other. And by Subway, the way a sandwich should be.
They changed things around now on this penalty.
Right, it was holding against the Bears. His number 48, Van Hiles. And you'll see him in the left side of the screen here. You see him right here. Now watch what he does. You see him? He has a guy there. Then he holds him and he takes him down right there. So that was a penalty. It wasn't against the kicking team.
Right,
it was against the receiving team. So then the ball, instead of being on the two-yard line, was half the distance to the goal line, which would put the ball on the one-yard line.
A one-yard penalty. They first indicated that it was going the other way.
Yeah, they said it was against the kicking team.
Right, right.
Then they changed and said it was against the receiving team. But in any case, it was still a 72-yard punt.
That's why I couldn't believe that they were going to refuse it. So Raymond Harris stands deep in his own end zone. He gets the carry out to about the three. Got a couple of yards.
Now, anytime you get backed up like this offensively, your first goal is to get the ball out to the five-yard line because your punter is 15 yards from the line of scrimmage. So you want to get him, you want to get out to this line here, then that gives your punter 15 yards. So that's the first thing. And then, of course, after you get past the five, then you try and get a first down and you just work down the field. But goal number one is the Bears need at least two more yards.
It's not a good feeling to be standing on anything but green. Out to about the four.
So you don't like to be thinking that you're going to have to punt, but you have to do that. And these are the things you have to do in football.
You have to get some room for your punter. Normally they get back 15 yards. If they get it out to the five, he can do back.
And you hate to do anything from the end zone, because if you punt from the end zone or you pass from the end zone and you have a holding penalty in the end zone, that's a safety. That's 2 points.
And if you stand on any part out of the end zone, that also is a safety. Accidentally stepped in that area. Too much time. Cowboys will probably decline this. I don't know that they have that option. They move it back half the distance to the goal line. Now they got to make up a couple of yards again to get back where they were.
Dave Wannstedt here coming back for the first time. He said this is the first time, of course, he was a defensive coordinator for years here under Jimmy Johnson for the Dallas Cowboys before he became head coach of the Chicago Bears. He said this is the first time he's been back here since he left in 1993. The first time Rick Meyer has ever played against the Dallas Cowboys.
5 years in the league. Here's the draw play from Raymond Harris, who gets out to about the 12. Some well-needed room for their punter.
Well, I think on that play there, they got a lot of their goals. One, as I said, you want to get past the five-yard line. And then second thing, you want to get a first down. Here they run a draw play, good crease, and that's all Raymond Harris needs. Boom, is that little crease. He goes right through that. He gets it to the five, then he gets it beyond the 10, and he gets a first down.
He got a first down.
That's pretty doggone good.
Yes, it is.
Already carried the ball 10 times for 37 yards.
And again, it's Harris.
Yeah, but the big thing that they're doing here, the Chicago Bears, is that they're eating up time on this clock. They're going to make it a short game, and they're keeping the Dallas Cowboy offense off the field. And I'll guarantee you, that frustrates. That not only frustrates the head coach, Barry Switzer, as you can tell by that expression, but that frustrates these other guys. I mean, Emmitt Smith is sitting there with a baseball cap on. You know, he's waiting to get in there. And these guys just keep the ball, and in doing so, are keeping the ball away from them.
Second down. Meyer back to throw. The Cowboys blitz. He's going deep and complete. Eric Smith covered by Kevin Smith. You know the word? Excuse me. Go ahead.
They go a little play pass and they get a little rollout and they are trying to get the ball deep. Again, they just signed Eric Smith, number 15, and he has the speed, and they're trying to get the speed. And it's interesting where they're doing it. All their passes have been to their right side. Whoever the receiver is, the corner that they want to work on, and you can tell the guy that they think is susceptible is Kevin Smith. They haven't thrown a ball yet on Deion Sanders.
They ran that way, but not passing. Meyer smothered by the rush. Cowboys will have to punt.
Yeah, that was Charlie Williams there. You know, we talk about the blitz and how you get the nickel and you're bringing the blitzes now and you just get the guy. See, here's Charlie Williams. He comes off that corner. He's the guy that Rick Meyer didn't see.
Right.
See, he's out there like he's going to cover against the slot. You see, and then instead of covering against the slot, he rushes the passer. Rick Meyer didn't count him and didn't see him.
Sauerbrunn's punt is a good one to Deion Sanders, who grabs it. Steps out of bounds at about the 45-yard, 46-yard line of the Cowboys. But they'll take over in a little better shape this time. 3-0. The Bears lead it.
Push the boundaries back with Goodyear Eagle F1. Dual aqua channel sweep water away for serious traction, especially in braking.
Serious freedom.
Calling Enterprise Rent a Car. Our car is sick.
Enterprise will arrange to pick you up.
Wow.
Drive you to our place and get you on your way.
Everybody loves to be picked up.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
It's the way a house smells when there's bread baking in the oven. The way mothers make sandwiches just right. It's the way we try to know each of our customers by name, or at least by sandwich. And it's the way all your favorite things combine into something even better. Right before your eyes. It's probably why people rate us number one in quality, survey after survey, even though it can be hard to answer questions with your mouth full. Subway. It's the way a sandwich should be.
Your heart's pounding, adrenaline's pumping.
They light you up, and you go.
We asked some of Hollywood's hottest stuntmen to switch antiperspirants and try Degree.
What's body heat activated?
Probably means when you get warm, that it starts working.
As your body heat rises, Degree releases extra protection when you need it most.
I heated up, and it cooled me down. I was on fire, and I was dry.
I don't want my guys to see me sweat. This stuff kept up, even in the 40-foot-high fireball. It's dry as a baby.
Body heat activated Degree. Your body heat turns it on.
If you have ambition and personality, you could be a star. James Brown hosts the coolest new series of the season, The World's Funniest, tonight at 7, 6 Central.
2:43 left in the first quarter. The Bears have controlled the ball and the number of plays, 21-4. And that's the kind of attack, that's the kind of plan you like to be successful at. Keep them off the field.
And like we said earlier, take this game into the fourth quarter where you still have a chance to win it and win it there.
That's LaFleur on the move. Hand off is to Emmitt Smith. Three or four. Stopped by Barry Minter.
Barry Minter did a good job of stepping up in there because he not only had to step up in the hole when he saw it, but then he had to take on the block of Moose Johnson. So he had three things. One, read it. Two, step up into the hole. Just watch him here, how he reads it. Then he steps up in the hole, takes on the block right there, plays off the block, and makes the tackle.
Yep. Second down. Bears short blitz. Emmitt Smith with the ball tripped up. It was knocked backwards right at midfield by Carl Simpson.
You know, this season it seems like Emmitt Smith just can't get started. And one thing is that the offensive line isn't blocking like they used to. The Cowboys are going without a huddle here.
Right.
But the other thing is defenses are penetrating more and getting him before he gets started.
On third down, Aikman. Incomplete. And there's the flag. Anthony Miller, the intended receiver.
And that was that slant, that timing pattern, three-step drop, 3 yard and slant. Tom Carter, the corner, riding it in there.
Pass interference, defense, number 25, automatic first down.
Here it is right here. It's going to be a slant. Here's Carter. Carter's the guy that they call the penalty on, Tom Carter. You see, you go up three and you slant to the inside. I don't know. That looks like pretty good defense to me. He got his right hand over and knocked the ball down without a heck of a lot of contact on Anthony Miller.
After he had knocked the ball down, then is when he made the contact.
Yeah, I think you have to allow a corner to do that. If a corner can't do that, he can't play in this league. That's good defense.
First and 10, that's Irvin in motion. Aikman back to throw it, and here they come after it. Aikman is waffled. Aikman knocked down hard by Barry Minter.
We're just talking about the play that Barry Minter made earlier, stepping up there. And Barry Minter is really going to step up this time. Watch him. He's coming late. You see, he comes right here. That's a delayed blitz. You know, he didn't come right now on the ball. You're going to see him. He's going to wait. He's right there in the middle. And he's just waiting and waiting and waiting. And now he comes. You see, he lets the protectors do the job that they have to. And then he comes on a delayed blitz. And as you said, he waffled. Oh, Troy Aikman.
Second and 10. Aikman goes on a quick count. This is Emmitt Smith. And Emmitt looked as if he had something, but got about three.
Yeah, Barry Minter, you know, used to play for the Cowboys, yeah. and if they don't get him blocked, he's gonna make all pro here today. He's the guy that made this tackle. He's the guy that made an earlier tackle coming off a block. He's the guy that blitzed and waffled Troy Aikman. Barry Minter came back here to Dallas ready to play football today, didn't he?
It's for Dealey. This is a highlight film for Barry Minter. Third and 8. We'll see if they blitz him this time. Set to rush. Here they come walking up. Flag on the play. Aikman has to throw off balance. Fires in the direction of Minter. But he had no time to set and throw in the direction of Miller, I should say, not Minter.
I think that's the thing that Troy Aikman is thinking. He's thinking about Minter and all the rushing and the thing that everyone's doing to the Dallas Cowboys now is they're just blitzing them every passing down, and the Bears are no different today.
No.
Illegal motion, number 48 on the offense. Penalties declined, fourth down.
And that's against Moose Johnston right here. And again, it's the blitz and the fake of the blitz. You see, he started to move like he was going to the outside, and he didn't reset. Usually what you teach a guy like that, when he starts to move like that, just go in motion, just keep going, because you can go in motion. But if you go like he did, then you have to reset for a second.
One can go in motion.
But I tell you, that's still good Bear defense. I mean,
really?
They're tackling well. They're going after Troy Aikman. They're doing all the things they have to do.
Toby going back to punt. They're not going to try to field this one into the end zone. Billy Davis was down trying to make the catch before it went in. The Bears control the first quarter and lead 3-0.
Search and find the energy the world needs to run. Run, world, run. Texaco, a world of energy.
Nice pants.
There's a man.
Dockers, khakis.
Someone in Springfield is hiding their secret identity.
I don't have to listen to these wild allegations.
And all new Simpsons tonight at 8, 7 Central.
3-0. The Chicago Bears lead the Cowboys. Trainers are looking at Mark Tuna.
I think when you start putting those drops in your eye like that, it probably has something to do with contact.
Probably, First and 10 Bears at their own 20.
He's blocking Brian Cox on that last play and probably popped the contact out.
Cox is almost intercepted. Intended for John Allred, their number one choice. And the man who they think will ultimately be the tight end on a regular basis for the Bears, incomplete. Almost picked off. 3-0 Chicago, 33 seconds left in the first quarter.
Well, like you say, you know, Keith Jennings is the starter, kind of blocker and not much of a receiver. And Ryan Wentnight is more of a receiver. And John Allred will probably be the combination guy that they want. They'll do both.
Two tight ends, two wide receivers, one back, Raymond Harris. And he gets the carry, stopped by Dexter Coakley.
You know, I will say this, that the tackling in this game is very good today. Both teams are tackling well. I mean, you know, that Raymond Harris, it looks like he's going to break something, boom, someone comes up and makes a tackle. And anytime the Cowboys have the ball, the Bear defense is really attacking their offense and tackling well.
It'll be 3rd and 7, and that'll be the end of the first quarter at Texas Stadium with the Bears leading the Cowboys by 3. Quarter number 2 coming up.
Dr. Pepper presents the lighter side of the game.
All right, guys, it all comes down to this last play. If we stop it here, we win. If they score, we lose. Billy, you've been screwing up all game. I need you to concentrate here.
All right, Bubba, you can count on me. I'm going to really get him this time.
Ready, set,
sorry, my fault. My fault, everybody. Do over.
Ready, set.
Hold it. I think I lost the contact.
No.
Nobody move.
Oh, get him.
These days, it seems like everything is the official something of somebody. What's next? The official soft drink? The team mascot? Look at this guy right here. And this one here. And his girlfriend and his kid. See? They're drinking Dr. Pepper just because it tastes great. It's kind of the official soft drink of everyone else. Like this guy with the bratwurst. He executes a one-handed twist. You can't coach this stuff. It's a thing of beauty. Hey, who's doing that? I do that.
At the Principal Financial Group, you'll find the strength of our investment performance is your 401k retirement advantage. You'll find our flexibility will meet your insurance needs. And you'll find the balance of choice and quality you need in health coverage. For over a century, you've trusted the Principal for strength, flexibility, and balance in retirement, insurance, and financial products. At the Principal, we give you an edge.
It's coming.
Come on, bring it on.
Hold on to your drawers.
No!
It's the King of the Hill that'll blow you away. Tonight after The Simpsons on Fox.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Dr. Pepper and your local Dr. Pepper bottler. Dr. Pepper, this is the taste.
We're back at Texas Stadium, where the Bears are leading 3-0. They have the ball. At least they're in the shade now. At their own 23, 3rd down and 7.
Now, it looks like this Cowboy defense is starting to wear down a little. The guys are starting to look a little tired out there.
Raymond Harris. That looks like enough for a first down.
I like the way Raymond Harris runs. I mean,
it's all out.
Yeah, he doesn't mess around. I mean, if he sees something, he takes it right now. I mean, there's no dancing, there's no going sideways, there's no going backwards, there's no going anywhere. It's just whack, and he just hits any crease or any opening he sees, and he doesn't even care who's in front of you.
First and 10 Bears on 3rd and 7. They run it and get the first. Flag on the play. Here's Raymond Harris.
Oh, they blew the whistle before
in the middle of the play.
It looked like to me that Shante Carver moved on defense, but it could have been Andy Heck. It was on the left side here, but they blew the whistle in the middle of the play. Now they should have either blown the whistle before the play started or after it's over. But the only thing they can say about blowing a whistle in the middle of a play is they have a word for it. It's called inadvertent. The guy didn't mean to do it, but he did it.
That sounded like that blow sounded like an I mean to whistle blow.
But you can't mean to in the middle of the play.
I mean, you either
blow the whistle before the play starts and it didn't count, or once it starts, you have to let it finish. This is a tough explanation here. How do you explain that one?
Well, that's the second tough explanation we had. They had
Wrong team going the wrong way a minute ago.
They're confused.
Neutral zone infraction, number 96 on the defense, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Yeah, that's wrong. I mean, then they still shouldn't have blown the whistle there. I mean, they still can't blow the whistle in the middle. I mean, for a defensive thing, you see that. I mean, you see the jump, and it was Shante Carver is who it was, but you can't blow the whistle now.
Now, no.
No, you let him run the play. If the offensive guy jumps, then you stop it. If the defensive guy goes, and you let him go, you got to let the play go to the end. There was no contact, and it was Shante Carver, 98.
Darnell Autry is in the backfield, and he gets the carry. Autry there, third-round pick from Northwestern, and it's been hot, we know that. Let's go down to Dan Jiggetts and see how hot.
As you can see down here, it's very hot. It's 80 degrees down here in the shade. As you get out on that field, though, Pat and John, it gets a lot hotter, and it is extremely humid. The cheerleaders are getting a heck of a workout, too.
Well, I wonder how you picked up that little note.
Well, Dan, Dan told me he lost like 20 or 30 pounds, so it's not as tough on him. You know, hot weather is always tougher on bigger guys than just little guys. You know that.
Dan qualifies. Raymond Harris, midfield.
The other thing is big guys always like wind chill better than humidity. Yeah, if you have a choice, wide receivers, running backs, quarterbacks, they will pick humidity, and big old linemen will always pick wind chill, and I think they're the same guy. I think the wind chill and humidity are the same guy, because when wind chill goes, humidity comes. When humidity goes, wind chill comes. You know what I mean?
I think I do. Are you a meteorologist? Is what I was going to ask you.
No. But I just know that if Dan said it's humid down there, then there's no wind chill.
That's good enough for me. Humid. Meyer gets the ball to Raymond Harris. Brought down by Randall Godfrey. Good play.
Your teams are trying to throw more screen passes, and if it's not red, or if you run the linebacker off, it could be a good play, but they don't run Randall Godfrey off. You see, and he's right up there, and he's man-to-man, and he just gets up and makes a tackle. Although Rick Meyer was hit on that play, and he got up slow. It looked like he hurt his knee on that play.
Darren Benson is getting playing time now, number 91. At defensive tackle for the Cowboys, and he is the biggest of all the tackles they rotate. Meyer, incomplete.
Meyer threw a duck. There was no one out there.
Ricky Prohl was the intended receiver.
But again, it's a blitz, and you see what happened. Darren Woodson came, and Darren Woodson wasn't picked up. It was a safety blitz. He's going to come up the middle. It's number 28, and you watch him. He's right here, and he's going to come and be free. And as Rick Meyer gets back there to throw, he sees Darren Woodson. You see him right there, and he made him come out to the side, and then he just had to throw that duck.
Now runs punt. Might be still in the field to play, and out of bounds it goes, and that's where it went out of bounds, at the 10 where they mark it. Van Hiles was down to bat it backwards. And so the Cowboys will take over at their own 10.
The internet
will create a new utopia.
To make us all smile.
We'll fix everything that's wrong in the world.
That's right.
Stop the hypertension before I get sick.
I created a channel.
I just sent my first email.
That's nice.
We're creating a virtual pet.
Yeah, that's useful.
Hey, what are you talking about doing?
Chrysler's score program using Lotus Notes on the web saved the company $1.2 billion.
Start.
All they want is someone to go down for the crime.
For two out-of-control cops.
The man in the car is DEA undercover.
The best place to hide.
We're going to find the killer.
Is behind a badge.
We are the killers.
Gang-related.
Rated R.
Starts October 8th.
If you love chocolate, peanuts, caramel, and especially Reese's peanut butter, good news. Reese's Nutrageous bars are now 20% bigger.
Cowboy offensive unit has not spent a lot of time on the field, but when they have, Aikman has been under a lot of pressure.
And you can see the effect that it had. He's thrown six passes. He's only completed one. His last five attempts have been incomplete.
Set to rush. Here they come.
But every time he goes back, he's getting rushed, and he's throwing off his back foot, and he's doing everything. I mean, they're on him every time he gets back there and set to throw.
Flannery has replaced Larry Allen at guard. Emmitt Smith sifting through tacklers, trying to find a running crease, and it's not available.
And that's been the whole season and the whole, I think, frustration for Emmitt Smith. I think part of it is Emmitt Smith. I watch him and don't think that he's running like he did a couple years ago. And two, I know that the blocking up front isn't like it was a few years ago. And then the third thing, I know the defenses are changing. And you're getting more blitzes. You know, we talk about the blitzes against Troy Aikman, but the Bears are also running run blitzes, and they're getting in the backfield before Emmitt Smith can get going.
Here's Aikman back to throw. Outside Urban. And Urban is taken down short of a first down by Walt Harris. You know, you're so right. The defenses are all different.
Yeah, and here's Michael Irvin out here and Walt Harris, and you see he just gets him up the field, little pushes off. Again, pretty good coverage and a good tackle by Walt Harris. But we can see that, you know, every down is a blitzing down. And they got guys coming inside. And yep. It seems like every time Troy Aikman throws the ball, he is either getting hit right as he throws it before or right after he throws it.
Third and two, he gets the ball out to Darryl Johnson. Broken tackles, finally stopped by John Mangum.
But I'll tell you, Paul Grosmanis really hit Troy Aikman after he threw that ball, or again, as he threw it. Watch number 93 coming right there. Boom! I mean, he hit him, and Troy Aikman's head just jolted right back. Watch his hit. I mean, that is a whack, and he got the ball out there and got the first down, but Troy Aikman has taken way too many hits, not only in this game, but in the game against Philadelphia and in the game against Arizona.
They got a first down at the 35. And again, the Bears show blitz. Almost there. Incomplete. And no flags this time. That was very close.
I'll tell you, did Emmitt Smith do a heck of a job of picking up Paul Grosmanis? Grosmanis comes straight up the middle again, and he's going to get Aikman again. Watch him. He's going to come straight up the middle, and here's Emmitt Smith here, and he just sees him and picks him off just before he gets to Troy Aikman. What? He's free right there. He's coming. And Emmitt Smith just picked him off.
And nobody blocked him. You're so right.
I know it. And if he doesn't, I mean, he's just going to drive Troy Aikman into that turf. But Emmitt Smith may not be running like he used to, but that was a big, big block.
There's the whistle again.
Now that whistle was before the play started, so that'll have to be against the offense here or contact by the defense. That one was definitely before the ball started.
Ball start, offense, number 63, 5-yard penalty, repeat second down.
That's John Flannery. Remember we told you that Larry Allen had a pulled hamstring, and they were going to try to see how long he could last. Obviously, he didn't last very long, and Flannery's taking his place.
I'll tell you, that's not a real strength of an offensive line now with Larry Allen out of there, and you have Clay Shiver at center and John Flannery at right guard. We're not talking about the best offensive line in pro football anymore here.
Second and 15. Aikman back to throw. Gets it out to LaFleur, the tight end. The ball bounced out of bounds. This guy is huge.
He is, and it was great coverage by Marty Carter. Marty Carter was right there with him. And again, I mean, he got the completion, but they didn't get any yardage there because of the good coverage.
Bear player down, Grosmanis.
Grosmanis was a guy that knocked Troy Aikman down a couple and almost got him before Emmitt Smith got him.
3-0. We're in the second quarter.
Two nearly identical Porsche 911s. One destined for Le Mans, the other for
for a quieter life in America. But then again, expecting any Porsche to lead a quiet life may be asking a bit too much.
Hi.
Porsche. There is no substitute.
No, this one's on us, sir.
Right.
How do you get this equipment to these troops when there's a river between them? Build a bridge. Problem solving. You need it now in college. Learn it now in the Army Reserve.
Even though he thinks a diet soft drink never tastes as good as a regular, he's decided to try a Diet Dr. Pepper. Well, it just goes to show things aren't always what they seem. Diet Dr. Pepper tastes more like regular Dr. Pepper.
Hey, I'm just going to try this one on.
Start preliminary testing with Emmett Smith in area.
Thank you for volunteering. We've been waiting for you. Here, have a seat.
All right, I want you to show some enthusiasm. So what if it's a little cold? I have to play in the snow. I want to hear some cheering and some clapping. Here's some wind. Okay, your starter approved.
Maybe this one.
Maybe you should try it on.
Starter, available at Champ Sports now.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Porsche, who wish to remind you there is no substitute. By Oracle, the company that's enabling the information age through network computing. And by Frost Brewed Coors Light, who reminds you the three most important words are hey, beer, man.
The Bears lead the Cowboys 3-0 at Texas Stadium. The Cowboys coming off a bye week. Everyone thought they, whatever problems they had, they'd figure them out and solve them. But the Bears have played very well.
You know, the Cowboys could be a team that are on the brink of something.
Yeah,
and maybe not the brink of greatness.
Here comes that blitz. Incomplete. Flag on the play. Steph Brett Williams was the intended receiver.
Yeah, and I think that time Tom Carter did grab him earlier on a slant. When they threw a slant in there to Anthony Miller, I thought Tom Carter had pretty good coverage. That time, from up here, it looked like Tom Carter
was
had,
early.
Yeah, it looked like he was early. It looked like he had his arm around his neck. Although he's saying that it's not a penalty against him. He's still arguing it.
What? And they're still
We're
talking it over.
We're setting a record here, I think, for these crew conferences. We've had like 10 crew conferences in this first half. I guess it's not against the Bears.
There's no foul on the play. The ball was behind the receiver. It is not catchable.
Fourth down.
Well, I don't like that rule. You know, that when a guy grabs a guy, how do you know that it's catchable? You know, if you watch him here, you see him grab him here.
Grabbed him by the face mask.
Well, maybe when the quarterback sees that, maybe he throws it high because the guy grabbed him. I mean, you can't do that to him and say that's okay. This officiating crew is off to a bad first half. You can't do that to a receiver.
The Cowboys will have to punt. Go on again. Tyrone Hughes back deep. This is a good kick. The coverage is down in a hurry. And a hustling Charlie Williams down. Good courage. Good coverage. That's Michael Lowry going for X-ray.
Why do I come out here? Because the playing field's level, but the stairs never are. Because if I can't get frost-brewed Coors Light to the fans cold, those guys in the Rockies froze their butts for nothing. So I scale concrete every night. Because somewhere there's a guy eating peanuts or some nachos, and he's thinking of me.
Coors Light! Coors Light!
Green Bay is a small town. When someone leaves here, it means something. It means the entire community has been diminished. It means an acquaintance, a neighbor, a friend has left your life forever. Most importantly, it means there's now some extra seats available. For Sunday's game.
Well, it's awfully tough to get tickets from the Super Bowl champs. It's absolutely impossible with American Express. So bring your Visa card.
Go Packers.
The official card of the NFL.
The new Porsche Boxster is assembled at Zuffenhausen, Germany. Much the same way our original roadsters, the spiders were assembled by human hands. Makes you wonder who builds other sports cars. The Boxster. Once again, there is no substitute.
If you had an affair with a married man, would you tell his wife?
He was a wonderful professor.
Ally McBeal, Monday at 9, 8 Central.
Pat Summerall, John Madden at Texas Stadium. 3-0, the Bears lead the Cowboys. Larry Allen has aggravated that hamstring pull. Again, can't play.
There's Brian Cox over there talking about that defense. These Bears are playing great defense today. They are getting after the Cowboys.
And they're doing well on offense as well. Controlling the ball. Pass complete. And right now, during McDonald's game break, let's return to James Brown at the Fox Television Center in Hollywood.
Pat, St. Louis Rams successful on this drive here as Tony Banks finds Amp Lee. Amp Lee finds pay dirt. Rams first trip to Oakland since 72 when John Madden was coaching. Right now leading 7-0. Pat and John.
Back in 72.
72 when I was coaching, we sent them right back where they came from, too, with a loss.
Back to Los Angeles.
Yeah, back to Los Angeles.
Not to St. Louis.
They weren't ahead 7-0 either. Where'd that come from? That was like venom.
That sounded like a little angry.
I know. I don't mean it. I'm sorry, JB.
Excuse me. Pass was caught and dropped by John Allred.
I'll tell you one thing about this game. This is good hitting. I mean, this is a good hitting game. You know, both defenses are crisp tackling. They're going after. They're blitzing. The special teams are, you know, getting downfield, making good tackles. The offenses, you know, really aren't doing a lot, but the defenses are very, very crisp, and there's some very, very hard hitting.
All these blitzes and different kinds of blitzes have made offense and picking up correct people kind of difficult. Pass is high, intended for Penn. And Rick Meyer watches the punting unit come on.
Yeah, and that was the first pass I think they threw on Deion Sanders, and that's a word out. If you're going to throw anything on Deion, you can't throw deep, and you can't throw out or comeback, but you can throw ins, crosses, and slants. And they tried to throw a slant on that down to Chris Penn against Deion Sanders. But I think I'd still try other things.
You better be concerned about this guy returning punts, too, if he has a chance. No chance. The ball out of bounds at the 40, and the Cowboys will take over with their best takeover position of the day.
People smile and tell me I'm the lucky one, and we've just begun. Think I'm gonna have a son. And in the morning when I rise, you bring a tear of joy to my eyes and tell me everything's gonna be alright.
Aflac, insuring over 40 million people worldwide.
Laugh and cry and fall in love. Movies touch us as few things can. Any technology that heightens the experience of watching movies at home makes life even more enjoyable.
DVD video from Philips Magnavox. Technology for the heart, the spirit, and the imagination.
David Cone and the Yankees take on Oral Hershiser and the Indians. The American League Division Series begins Tuesday on Fox.
3-0. The Bears lead Dallas. 7:27 left before halftime.
Emmett Smith so far only has 4 carries, Pat, for 6 yards, so they haven't gotten him going yet. And that was one of their goals. That was one of Emmett Smith's goals. That was also one of the Cowboys' offensive goals, is to get their running game going and to get Emmett Smith going.
Here's Aikman. Outside to Bjornson. Very little gain, if any. Brian Cox made the stop. We will be on the road again next week, of course, in Green Bay, and so will the pregame show. Second time that that cast has come to Green Bay. And look at the NFC Central standing. Tampa Bay visits Green Bay next week, and Detroit, with that victory today over the Packers, is 3-2, the same record as Green Bay. Tampa Bay 5-0.
Who would have thought it, before the season, you said, what team in the NFC is going to